بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه ومن والاه. Still under the main title of correcting misconceptions, even though we always say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to worship Him, and some people they say, why do this? We do it for the sake of Allah. Why do that? We do it for the sake of Allah. So Allah. نعبد الله لأن الله أمرنا. The question always is raised from some people, but does Allah need our worship? Why He's commanding? Why not to leave us for our freedom, for example? It's a valid question. But does Allah need? Definitely He does not need. So let's go to Qudsi Hadith, which will help us to understand. Then we have the simple conclusion. Very famous hadith where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this hadith Qudsi, Ya ibadi, لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم كانوا على أتقى قلب رجل منكم ما زاد ذلك في ملكي شيئا. Oh my servants, if all of you, the beginning of you, the last of you, all of you, the best of you, the jinn, the human, all of you, you were like the best of you, all of you, my kingdom, my power, what I own will not be increased. You are not giving me added value if you were good people. يَا عِبَادِي لَوْ أَنَّ أَوَّلَكُمْ وَآخَرَكُمْ وَإِنْسَكُمْ وَجِنَّكُمْ كَانُوا عَلَىٰ أَفْجَرِ قَلْبِ رَجُلٌ مِّنْكُمْ. If all of you, you were like the worst of you, مَا نَقَصَ ذَلِكَ مِنْ مُلْكِي شَيْئًا. My power, my kingdom will not be decreased. I'm losing nothing. إِنَّمَا هِيَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ. Then he continued. قَالَوْ أَنَّ أَوَّلَكُمْ وَآخِرَكُمْ وَإِنْسَكُمْ وَجِنَّكُمْ سَأَلُونِي فَأَعْطَيْتُ كُلَّ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْكُمْ مَسْأَلَتَهُ مَا نَقَصَ ذَلِكَ مِنْ مُلْكِ إِلَّا كَمَا يُنْقِصُ الْمِخْيَطُ إِذَا أُدْخِلَ الْبَحَرِ. If all of you, your human beings, the jinn, the human, you ask me, whatever, just name it, keep asking, and I gave everyone the best of what he wishes, this will take out of my kingdom and my power and my creation that I own, like when you put the needle inside the sea and you remove it, what is the amount of water that the needle takes from the sea? Zero. This is how the power of Allah, or the, you know, the, if I may put it, what Allah owns, if my body, what He created, will be decreased, which is nothing. Then he could have said, إِنَّمَا هِيَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ أُحْصِيهَا لَكُمْ. It's just your deeds, and I'm counting them for you. فَمَنْ وَجَدَ خَيْرًا فَلْيَحْمَدِ اللَّهِ. If you found the end result, the day of judgment, good, just say thanks and praise your Lord. وَمَنْ وَجَدَ غَيْرَ ذَلِكَ فَلَا يَلُومَنَّ إِلَّا نَفْسَهُ. And if anyone found something else, something else, this is the disaster, the error of Iran, قال فَلَا يَلُومَنَّ. Don't blame except himself. So why Allah is commanding us? Does Allah benefit? Definitely no. Is there any kind of increasing in His divinity? Like في ازدياد في ألوهية الله when I do sujood for Him? No. But if I refused to, no. But why Allah is commanding us? It's for our benefits. He loves us. He's organizing our life. Now, what benefits us has been designed in a way it's for Allah, so that to be given the, you know, the importance to be done, and at the end, I am the one who's benefited. It's not Allah, it's me. But why am I rewarded or I'm punished? It's not because of the action itself, it's because of the attitude. Am I respecting Allah or not? So let's know now. Actually, the worship itself does not mean Allah, whether I've done it or not. Because, for example, prayer, is it important or something silly in Islam? Important. It's the only verdict, the only hukum, the only legislation that has been sent to Prophet Muhammad while he was in Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, when he was in the seventh heaven. True or false? Type it. If I can't pray while I'm standing, I can, for example, do it while I'm sitting. If I can't, I sleep. If I lost my conscious, Allah will forgive me. If I can't do it with the proper wudu, no problem. If I don't have the, I can't do tayammum. If I don't have the tayammum, فَقَدْ التَّهُورَيْنِ. Which means it's not something, it's a matter of am I respecting or am disrespecting. Okay? That's why, for example, do it. Sometimes some people, they are allowed to do prayer, okay? Even if they don't have wudu. You know, they, I don't know in English what they call it. They عندهم السلس البول. هذا طبيا مين فيكم أعرف المصطلح. سلس. سلس البول وسلس الريح. في هذا دكتور شيء؟ ها؟ شو المصطلح؟
ممكن بشق تحته.
هذا مصطلح. You know, when you can't control your muscles, the muscles of your bladder, and the urine, you know, just, you know, leaves its place and it, you know, it is a problem. It's called in Arabic salas al-bol. It's a medical problem, which means it causes the urine or the stool or the wind from your body, you know, to come out. Which when it breaks the wudu or it makes all of your body full of najasa. Yet in Islam, if this is something beyond your control, you are completely forgettable. You can pray with all the najasa in your body. Ya Allah! So the problem is not with the najasa. The problem with respecting the commandments. That's why, ya Ahibba, the point is respecting the commandments. That's why, for example, let me finish with this. Some people ask, they say, is it true that Allah is just? They say, no, Allah is not just. Allah is justice. Allah مش عادل. Allah العدل. The source of justice. طيب, if Allah is justice, yeah, Mr. Believer, why it's the case if I'm a bad person, I'm an atheist, I'm a kafir, I'm whatever. Imagine that I lived for 60 years. I'm supposed to be punished for 60 years. Why it's the case that I will be eternally in the hellfire? Mr. Mu'min, some atheists, they ask us this question. And if you are a good person, good, pious, righteous person, and you worship, you obeyed your Lord for example, 60 years, why it's the case that eternally you will be rewarded? What is justice? I say, you missed the point. It's not mathematical calculations. Now, we have 2 points here, and we finish with this. Point number one, the punishment and the reward is not for the number of years of worship, it's for the attitude. Am I rude with Allah? Or I do admit that He's the Creator and I was falling in short and I'm sorry, Ya Allah, or I'm obeying or disobeying the arrogance. I mean, the evidence for this dalil, the attitude of Iblis. What was the problem of Iblis? It's an attitude. What's good? No. Mathematically, it was maybe a matter of a few minutes. Okay? What's good? Ya Allah, بس مشان هيك ما عمل الله زعل منه. No. It's not the physical action. It's the arrogance, the attitude, refusing. It's Allah who's asking this. So this is from one angle. From another angle now, here comes the importance of the niyyah, the attitude, which is important of the niyyah. Now, if Allah knows if He kept my life, my soul and my body, for another maybe 1,000 years, when He decided to take my soul, He knows that if I'm still like this, I will be doing what I'm doing, which is, it's good or bad. So I've taken my opportunity. By this, let's conclude. Concluding, the importance of respecting Allah, of doing any kind of ibadah, is to respect the commandments of Allah. The one who will be benefited, it's not Allah, it is ourselves. JazakAllah khair.